Hello, and welcome to our video series on HR-driven provisioning with Azure AD. I'm Rahul Nair, a product manager on the Entra Azure AD engineering team at Microsoft.
Hello, my name is Chetan Desai, and I'm also a product manager on the Azure AD team working on HR provisioning integrations.
In this video, we will be covering top-of-mind questions that every IT admin or system integrator has when configuring this feature. So, let's get started. Chetan, how about we start with a quick overview of this feature and its benefits?
Sure, Rahul. So Azure AD Identity Provisioning Service is a cloud-managed service that's part of Azure AD, and it enables four distinct scenarios as shown here. Number one, it allows you to source enterprise identities from HR apps. Today, we offer native connectors for Workday and SAP SuccessFactors integration. You can sync worker data from these HR apps either to your on-premises AD domains or to your cloud Azure AD tenant. The second flow shown here is synchronizing identities between your on-premises AD domains and Azure AD tenant. Once all your identities are present in Azure AD, you can use flow number 3 and 4 to manage user accounts in SaaS apps and your on-premises apps. In this video, we will discuss about scenario number 1, HR-driven user provisioning.
This is a great visual representation of the big picture. I can see how integrating Azure AD with HR apps can help IT teams configure access, lifecycle workflows, and provisioning rules based on the user's HR attributes. So, how does one actually go about planning this integration?
That's a good question. The first step is to identify what type of provisioning integration you'd like to configure. There are four different types of HR integrations that one can configure with Azure AD. Let's take a close look at each integration scenario. The first integration scenario is what we call the HR writeback scenario. Use this integration if you want to write back IT-managed attributes like email, username, and phone to the HR app. This integration only updates attributes in your HR app. It does not create any users. The second integration scenario enables direct flow of HR data to your Azure AD tenant. Use this integration if you have cloud-only users in your Azure AD tenant that don't need an on-premises AD account. The third integration scenario enables direct flow of HR data to your on-premises AD domain. Use this integration if you have a single AD domain and you want to sync standard user attributes with basic attribute transformations. The fourth integration scenario is a medium complexity flavor involving a single AD domain or forest. Your integration may resemble this scenario if you want to pull custom HR attributes and add OU routing logic. For example, creating a user in a specific AD container based on the HR department value. And the fifth integration scenario is the high complexity flavor involving multiple AD domains or forests. Your integration may resemble this scenario if your AD domains are segmented by region, business unit, or subsidiaries, and you have a delegated administration model.
Okay, so let's say as an IT admin, I want to configure integration scenario 1 and integration scenario 3. Is there a specific order that I would need to follow?
That's a good question. All these integration scenarios are independent of each other. There is a separate provisioning application in the Azure AD Enterprise App Gallery for the three integration scenarios: writeback, provisioning to Azure AD, and provisioning to on-premises AD. So you can start your HR provisioning integration journey with any scenario.
Got it. Okay. Now let's talk about the last three integration scenarios involving inbound data flow from HR apps to on-premises AD. What are the solution components that we need to be configured in this flow?
So there are two main solution components involved in this flow. The first component is the Azure AD Provisioning Cloud Service, and the second component is the on-premises Azure AD Connect Provisioning Agent. The HR connectors provided by the provisioning service periodically query the HR data source for worker data changes. As soon as a change is detected, the provisioning service transmits the change to the provisioning agent, which then performs the last mile update in AD. The change in Active Directory is then synchronized to Azure AD using either AD Connect Sync or Cloud Sync. As discussed earlier, optionally, if the IT team wants to write back certain IT-managed attributes to the HR app, they can configure the attribute write back flow.
Right. So once the IT team configures these solution components, HR worker data will automatically sync to Azure AD and all connected apps. But what if the IT team wants to take automation to the next step and integrate joiner, mover, and leaver automation?
Oh, the good news there is that Azure AD now offers a feature called Lifecycle Workflows that the IT team can use to configure custom workflows for joiner and leaver scenarios. For example, using HR-driven provisioning, the IT team can fetch the start date of a new hire from the HR app and then configure a workflow to execute 5 days before the new hire start date, which will send an email notification to the hiring manager and generate a temporary access pass for first-time login.
That's great to know. So to summarize, using the HR-driven provisioning capability, along with lifecycle workflows, enables IT teams to roll out end-to-end joiner and leaver automation. Thank you for joining us today, and we hope you found this session useful. Join us for our next videos that cover integration steps specific to Workday and SuccessFactors HR apps.